Within this time, I learned these 5 crucial steps and just all around making sure your money is your money and not the next billionaire. My channel, my name is Official Monroe Brooke. If you guys are new, welcome. And if you are returning love bug, hey boo, hey. So if you are new to my channel, my name is Monroe Brooke. I am a 24-year-old entrepreneur and beauty mogul and just all around a joyful person to know. So far, if you guys have liked what you heard, I would love for you guys to become a subscriber to my channel and become a fellow love bug by clicking the subscribe button down below. Also giving this video a thumbs up. That helps me out a lot to know what type of videos you guys like to see and just to be interactive with you guys so I can get the algorithms together. Secondly, I would love if you guys follow me on all my social medias like my Instagram, my Snapchat, and my Twitter. I'm more active on there now than ever before. So I really appreciate that. And let's go ahead and get into the video. So in today's video, I'm going to give you guys 5 tips on how I went from $546 to $50,000 within a few months and hitting rock bottom. So let's get into the video. So if you guys do not know my backstory, I'm going to give you guys a little emphasis on that. I was born in St. Louis, Missouri. I'm the youngest of 7 children to a single mother. And pretty much at the age of 13, 14, I had to grow up and basically take care of myself. There are a lot of things that transpired, which we're not going to get into, but I talked about that in previous videos. If you guys go on my channel to watch those. But pretty much I have to grow up very, very quick, and I grew up watching pretty much my mom hustle when I was younger. But once I had to grow up for myself, I pretty much watched my brother teach me the game and teach me how to just become the person that I've always wanted to become and be successful. So watching him throughout my teen years in high school, I learned a lot. And within that time, I set goals for myself and I put plans forth in the future to actively pursue those goals and try to work my hardest. At the age of 17, I was denied my dream college, but I was accepted by my second choice, which was Clark Atlanta. However, I did get accepted. Long story short, I did not have the funds. I could not take out a loan. I did not have any help or any support. I was homeless and they wanted their money and I wasn't able to give it. So I was pretty much a college dropout. After this crazy situation, I went ahead, I moved to Florida and I took out loans at a Florida college. Things did not transpire the way they were supposed to. So my sister was very nice enough to take me in and I went back to Georgia. And when I was living with her, pretty much I worked my ass off. This is where the pressure came in and this is where everything came in as far as that weight of adulthood being put on my shoulders. And within this time, I learned these 5 crucial steps actually led me to great success and will still continue to lead me to great success, which I wanted to share with you guys. So for number 1, it was saving and living within my means. So basically pretty much living within your means is you are not exceeding, okay, what is coming in. So say for instance, you're only bringing in $1,200 a month after taxes, you need to be able to live off half of that. This might sound crazy, but it is very important. Saving your money is the biggest thing you can possibly do. So pretty much I learned this very, very quick. I had several jobs. I worked at Wendy's, I worked at Burger King, I worked at a call center, and I worked at Home Depot warehouse. So I had to learn to live within my means and not live beyond. I kind of learned it a little bit later, but I still learned it. This means sacrificing those weekends with your friends. This means sacrificing not going on vacation. This means sacrificing not having the latest and the greatest handbag, not having the new phone, not having that condo apartment you want and you see everybody with, not having that brand new car, cooking at home, and just all around making sure your money is your money and not the next billionaire. For me, this became apparent. I had to realize what was actually worth it and what wasn't. So if I knew that I had $1,200 coming in a month, I wasn't going out to buy the new Air Jordans. I wasn't going out to buy the new wig install. I wasn't going to Fashion Nova and spending $600 just because I can save $100. I was actively saving my money. And I implement this more now in my adult life because obviously I have more bills. I did have the comfort of living in my sister's home rent-free for a little bit of time before I started to pay rent to her, but it was all a learning lesson. I'm 24 and what I've been doing since I turned 23 is I signed up for this app called Albert. I'll leave it down below in the description box. If you join, they give you like free money or something like that. Pretty much Albert takes out money out of your account a week. So you can have a set amount, to take out. Me, I started out with $25, then I raised it up to $50, and I raised it up to $75. One time I went up to $125, but I dropped it back down to $75. It depends on whatever you are comfortable with taking out a month. And pretty much it takes the money out and puts it in a separate savings account so that you cannot touch it. It's, you don't have a card to this account. You don't have like something where you can just actively swipe it and use that money. So this is a savings account. If you need to go in, they'll happily let you take the money out, but they also help track what you're spending your money on, where your finances are going, how much money you have, basically your net worth. It tells you everything. It helps you open up an IRA. It helps you save towards a mortgage. It helps you save towards a lot of different things. And saving is the key. This app actually helped me cancel a bunch of my subscriptions that I wasn't using. It helped me understand my phone bill and where I could save in my phone bill. So I ended up buying my phone outright and then switching carriers, and my phone bill went from $120 to $35. It also showed me where I was eating out, how much money I was spending eating out, and just it showed me the mistakes that I was making that I wasn't actively seeing in my day-to-day life, because I'm not looking at my bank account every 20 minutes to see where my money is going. I'm just spending it. Well, I was just spending it because I knew that I had it, which is not a good mindset. You want to save as much as possible and stack your money. The second step was reassessing my friends and the people that I hung out with. I had to understand the difference between an asset and a liability. If it is an asset, it is bringing you fortune, it is bringing you greatness, it is bringing you good. If it is a liability, it is taken away, it is draining, it is devaluing what you are trying to do. And yes, people can be assets or liabilities. If you ask any millionaire, they'll probably say the same exact thing. Anybody who is successful in general will tell you this, trust me. So I had to reassess the people I was hanging out with, the things that I was doing, the things that I was also consuming, which is very important. So when it came to the people that I was hanging around, I had to understand, do these people have goals? Are these people like-minded like me? Are they trying to be better than what they are now? Are they trying to grow? Are they looking for different ways of growing? And third, were they a support to me? Were they a part of my support system? I didn't want to be around friends who just wanted to drink all the time. I didn't want to be around friends who wanted to party all the time. I didn't want to be around friends who wanted to gossip all the time. I wanted to be around people who are supporting me and who I can also support in a good, positive way. Once I figured out those three things and I sat back and I watched and I assessed, I had to make decisions on who was making the cut and who wasn't making the cut. And a lot of people unfortunately didn't make the cut. But I realized that's okay. It's okay to not speak to someone because you guys just don't have goals that align with each other. It's okay. People grow apart. People come in your life for reasons and seasons, and that is totally okay. And this also goes for family. Sometimes you have to reassess the family members you hang around with, because even though they are blood, they might not have your best intentions in mind. For number two, I had to reassess what I was giving my time and my energy to as well. So this meant my free time. What was I actually doing my free time? And when I looked at that, most of the time I was sitting in front of a TV watching television, watching reality shows like Bad Girls Club and Love and Hip Hop, things that were bringing me no benefit but also tainting my energy and how I thought. I was scrolling on Instagram, I was on Snapchat, I was on things that had no viable meaning or no viable return for my goals in the future. So basically it came down to what I was consuming and whether or not it brought me joy, but not just any kind of joy. It was mentally, physically, emotionally, and financial joy overall. I feel like a lot of times young people drown themselves into things that are feeding your dopamine for the moment, but not feeding your dopamine for a lifetime. So for number three is having active and passive income. If you guys don't know what that means, I'm going to explain. The difference between active and passive income is very simple. Active income is pretty much a 9-to-5, something you are actually giving in your energy to. So that means if you have a part-time job or a full-time job, putting in 35 to 30 hours for a part-time, or putting in 40 plus hours for a full-time job, that is an active income. Now, me personally, I had both. I was working at Burger King, I was working at the call center, I was doing all these things also while having a passive income, like my business, my YouTube channel, things like that. So for my active income, I was doing off the bat what I knew naturally and what I loved doing. hair. Hair was my number one thing. I sat around for a very long time debating on whether or not I was going to be able to actually get clients in a new city, in a new state, and do things like that, especially in Georgia, where I feel like it was oversaturated and people pretty much had their go-to stylists. But I took a leap of faith and I put myself out there. I put myself on Stylesy. I put myself on Craigslist. I went to cosmetology school. I took the active way about going into making money. I did all of this and I was sitting home, and there would be days and weeks where I would make no money, and there would be days and weeks where I would make $1,000 a day, I would make $600 a day, I would make $200 a day, but I was being active within doing that. When I saw that that was bringing in money, I also ended up getting an extra job. I just wanted to get out of the house. I didn't want to be sitting in my sister's house all day. I ended up working on a military base. I ended up working at a call center, and I was struggling with both of those jobs and also doing hair. So I was going back and forth just with time management, which I'm a little bit better at now, a lot better at now, honestly. But I was just going back and forth between those three and really, really hustling. And that was my active income, putting in time in exchange for money. And when it came to my passive income, that led into my hair business that I had launched back in high school. By now, the name has changed. I went from one brand name to my active brand name now, which is The Official Glam Co. on Instagram. I hope you guys can follow that down below. I went from that one active name to another active name, and I really put time and energy into what I was putting out there into the world, and I invested in myself. I had a bunch of clients always asking me for makeup and always asking me for hair, and I wanted to be able to supply that to them without recommending something else that made someone else money but didn't bring money into my own pockets. For some reason, I was a free billboard for several different companies, and people actually invested money into those companies, which could have went into my pocket. So passive income was very, very huge with my business. I let that run itself. I did do a little promotion on my free time, like when I got off work, or like on my lunch break or something like that. I would be on my Instagram and promoting it and stuff like that. Even through my YouTube channel, I also promoted it, and just through word of mouth. So that was my passive income. Then came along YouTube, where I actually started making money. So when I first started YouTube, I did not know I could make money from it. I've been on YouTube since like 2009, 2008, that time, but I wasn't making money back then, and I was doing singing videos. But once I started my actual beauty channel, Official Monroe Brooke, and I hit a certain amount of subscribers, back in the day it was based off subscriber count, I started making money from my YouTube. And from my YouTube, all that passive income, I pretty much reinvested it back into YouTube, buying more lighting, buying more cameras, buying different things that I needed for my YouTube channel to actually keep growing. I was consistent with that, and for a while that became my only income, because I got stagnant and because I was getting brand deals and things like that. But it was passive income. I would just take my free time out of the day and just record, while also carrying on my job at the time before I got really stagnant with YouTube. But I had other passive incomes coming in as well. But I ended up making YouTube like my main source. I quit my jobs and I made this my main source, along with my businesses, which I was stagnant with for a while, but it ends up working out in the long run, and I am where I am today, which I'm very grateful and thankful for. And it has pretty much humbled me and to learn the value of money, which is why I'm here speaking to you guys. So pretty much my tips for this is to invest in yourself, start your own business, but I will say, please do not try to quit your job and have your own business or start your own business unless the business is bringing in more money than your job would have ever brought in. And if you are able to make your own business, reinvest in yourself. Don't go take the money that you have and then go spend $1,000 of the money you just earned from your business on a Gucci belt. Do not do that. It's not worth it. No matter how many people you see on Instagram living a lavish life, do not do it, because it is all a facade. Live for you and live in your financial means, which is back to step number one. So reinvest in yourself and don't spend your money frivolously just to have the look and not really live the life. So step number four is to learn new skills and never stop learning. Whether it's college or whether it's just learning a skill, never stop learning. There are so many master classes out here. There are so many coding classes, different skill classes that you can take and actually invest in for your future, which doesn't mean you have to go take the typical route, which is college and get out of student loan and go into debt and all these kind of things. So I have this saying, an entrepreneur knows when they're an entrepreneur because they don't want to clock in. And that is my motto. I took that leap of faith after having endless nights of crying about the job that I hated and being stagnant. And I took that and I rolled with it and I literally believed in myself. I learned new skills. I learned new things. I read books. I listened to podcasts. I watched so many videos on self-growth and self-worth and just learning my individual worth and what I can take and what I can learn and make and shape and excel at. And like I said, there are so many different master classes out here. If you want to do lashes, you can learn how to do lash extensions. If you want to do makeup, you can learn how to do makeup. Makeup by Mario has these master classes and I'm pretty sure he makes a lot of money from that. But he took a skill and he's teaching it to other people who want to learn. He worked on his craft. He worked so hard day and night, endless nights, I'm pretty sure. He's known as Kim Kardashian's makeup artist, but he's more than that. He has set trends. He has created his own makeup brand. He's done so many things to put himself in a position where he probably never thought he could be 10 years ago. So all I say is just to never stop learning and to always want to progress and keep up that energy to learn more and seek more ways to educate yourself. So for number five, this tip is to be consistent. It's the saying by Dwayne The Rock Johnson about consistency that I always think about. Success isn't always about greatness. It is about consistency. Consistent hard work leads to success. I think in the climate that we live in now, everybody feels obligated to success. Everybody feels like everything's supposed to be handed to them and you don't have to work for it. Absolutely wrong. If you want something bad enough, you're gonna work and you're gonna be consistent towards what you want to actually achieve those goals and never, ever, ever look back on what you did and look down on it. You always need to stay consistent and be able to look back at what you did and see where you went wrong, see where you went right, and take that and implement it into something new towards your goal. I know some people are gonna probably say, well, Brooke, you stopped doing YouTube for a while. I did stop doing YouTube for a while, but I had other sources of income and I was very consistent with that. I took a break from YouTube and that's okay. If you take a break at something, but you always have something else to back you up, that's totally fine. I took a break, I reevaluated myself, I reevaluated my life all over again. I had to do this like 3 or 4 times, but guess what? The place that I am in now, no one can tell me differently. When I was consistent, I reaped the benefits of it, and I understand that. So pretty much just stay consistent at what you're doing. Honestly, if I would have stopped at just getting 100 views on YouTube, I would have never had 1 million views on videos. I would have never had 100,000 views on videos. I would never have 500,000 views on videos. I would never even had 10,000 views on videos. Whatever the number was, I would have never had that if I wasn't consistent to begin with. So for consistency, the one thing that I stay focused and true to is that where I'm at now is not where I'm gonna be at in 10 years. As long as I stay consistent and as long as I'm doing my due diligence and working hard towards those goals. I didn't just set one goal or two goals. I set 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 goals and I have marked off a lot of those goals and I'm still marking them off and I'm still achieving to this day. When I tell you guys, I literally went from $546 to $50,000 within less than a year. I couldn't even imagine it. And even though I probably didn't do all the right things with it or I didn't go about it the right way, it was a learning lesson. And this the position that I am in now, it makes me look back at that and I'm very thankful and grateful that I did that and how I did it and how hard I hustled to get there. And no matter what your circumstances are, or no matter what your situation is, you can always become better than the person you were a day ago, 2 hours ago, a minute ago. Like the meme that always says, I'm not the same person that I was 5 minutes ago. Literally, you're not, because you learn something every day, every second, every minute, every hour. And it's about what you actually learn and what you implement into the next step. So I do want to give you guys one extra tip, which I live by every single day. So pretty much you have to be willing to change and grow. So for me, I have to be willing to change a lot of things that I was doing that I was very stagnant about in my life and able to become the woman that I am today. I feel that in life in general, it's all about growth and personal growth, mental growth, physical growth, emotional growth, all of those type of growths and financial growth as well, to be able to become a better person. I feel like if you are okay with being stagnant, you will continue to do the same things that you've always done and stay in the same place. But if you are willing to change and you're willing to grow and change your mentality and change your outlook on life and use these steps in your everyday life, you will grow and flourish to become a beautiful woman, a beautiful man that you couldn't even imagine of becoming or that you always wanted to become. So I send nothing but love, light, and positive energy to you guys. I'm always here if you guys need support and help. I love you guys so much. And I hope to see you guys in my next video. I hope you guys decided to subscribe. And I love you guys so much. And I'll see you guys in my next video. Mwah.